Physicists explain how air conditioning can spread COVID-19. A new study showed a factor behind the spread of coronavirus indoors. Physicists found that relative humidity in closed spaces with active air conditioning could raise transmission risk. The climatic factor could allow liquid droplets to be suspended longer. The longer the droplets were suspended, the higher the risk of contracting COVID-19. Dr. Ajit Alawat, first author of the study and physicist at Tropos in Leipzig, Germany, said, "In aerosol research, it has long been known that air humidity plays a major role. The more humid the air is, the more water adheres to the particles and so they can grow faster." The team evaluated 10 most relevant international studies of humidity on the survival, spread, and transmission of viruses. These studies were conducted between 2007 and 2020 and covered influenza, SARS-CoV, MERS-CoV, and SARS-CoV-2. For coronaviruses, relative humidity indoors could affect the spread in three various ways. These are the behavior of the pathogens inside liquid droplets, the inactivation or survival of viruses on surfaces, and the role of dry air in airborne transmission. Physicists identified that low humidity causes liquid droplets in the air to dry quickly. But low humidity would not reduce the survivability of coronaviruses. While different processes could be involved, the team estimated that humidity of indoor air below 40% would make liquid droplets emitted by people lighter. The liquid droplets would absorb less water and fly at greater distances indoors. It would increase the exposure of more people. On top of that, low humidity caused by air conditioning could dry the mucous membranes inside the nose. This would result in greater permeability of viruses into the respiratory system. The findings resembled the insight into the spike cases of influenza during colder months. The team suggested humidifying indoor air to prevent dryness. In colder months, people often activate heating systems to endure cold temperatures. But typical systems lack mitigation to dry air. If the humidity has been increased indoors, liquid droplets emitted through coughing, sneezing, or talking will be heavier. Physicists calculated that 40% humidity in public buildings and transport could reduce transmission of COVID-19, seasonal influenza, and other similar viral diseases. For countries with cool climates, the 40% humidity is the recommended minimum. For countries with hot climates, air conditioning systems must not cool the air too much to achieve the same 40% humidity. If possible, allow fresh air from the outside to promote air circulation inside. Air circulation welcomes fresh air and removes unclean air, including viral particles. The findings were published in the journal Aerosol and Air Quality Research.